this rugged path that we chose to make a living. You know, it's a grind at times, but it can be so rewarding. We're excited to take you along the journey in 2020 as we live life on the cut line.
Test takes about 15 minutes or so, and you can't leave because they want to know if you've got it or not. So we're just sitting here waiting.
Let's go fishing. Otherwise, I'm smallmouth. I'll just get it behind the hook.
There, little fella.
Normally, when we come to the St. Lawrence River, I would never largemouth fish, but being the circumstances as they are and us not being able to go to Canada and the lake being open, and it's kind of a weird deal. So I feel like you may possibly find the winning place out there on the lake, but the chances of going out there and fishing it 4 days are very slim. So we're gonna use these first 2 days and just try to figure something out in this river to get you by on those days that we can't go out there. And hopefully we'll find something, you know, out there that'll be worth going to. But it's too windy the first 2 days. I mean, it's been blowing 25 to 30 the first 2 days of practice. So we're spinning it on the river, and I'm sampling the largemouth. You know, it has a good, this place has a good population of largemouth, and you know, if you've got a good lead and you can't go out there the last day, this is something that could save a tournament. So it's all part of the process.
River for the third stop of the elites, and the way this thing sets up is like you got the Great Lakes, Lake Ontario, and then it necks down into this river, and this river's got a bunch of current to it. It's probably got, you know, anywhere from 2 or so to 3 mile an hour worth of current. So all you can do is drift. If you fight it, you end up, you know, if you try to hold yourself on a spot, you'd kill your batteries, or you know, it wouldn't work. So what we do here, or what most people do here, is you drift like over a point or anywhere that's a high spot or anything like that. And you know, you use a Ned rig or a drop shot. I've been drop shotting a big bite smallie smasher and a Ned rig. Caught a lot of fish, nothing, you know. Here, it's crazy. You've got to have 20 pounds a day, which is unreal smallmouth fishing, but this place is phenomenal. So just kind of drifting around. Don't fight the current, use the current. And you can cover a lot of water with it. And once you get on these good drifts, you'll know, you know, if they're biting it on the up current side of the hump or on the down current side right on top of it. So that's what we're doing. We'll keep pecking away and see if we can't find the wad of them.
I did what the worst thing you can do on this place. I just ran all over and did everything from largemouth to the lake, fish deep in the river, fish shallow in the river, instead of just picking an area. That's all you can do here, yeah. I think.
But with everything being off limits.
Yeah.
What could you do?
It's different, that's for sure. I don't understand how it could be that. Do you think that, well, they just cut half the river off. It's not going to be that big of a deal, but you go to looking at what you fished in the past, where you caught them in the past, and it's, you're like, man, 90% of it's in Canada. It's no good now, so I don't know. It could be really bad, or I had to figure something out tomorrow, or I'm going the opposite direction, I feel like, but it's part of it. I kept telling myself out there on the water today, I'm like, if I hadn't talked to anybody or knew anything else and just went off my practice, what would I do? And that would be what I would do, because that's the only place I got multiple 3.5 pound bites and saw some quality fish up shallow. The wind's not gonna blow. And then I'm actually thinking if I can catch somewhere around 17 pounds, I might stroll on out to the lake and go back in search mode, because I'm not gonna fish stuff. I mean, the shallow stuff that I got around takeoff, I can fish in like 2 hours.
Yeah.
So I can hit it right before I do in. And it's really gonna depend on if the sun comes out. You know, that's a big factor. I feel like if it's cloudy, your shallow stuff is not in play.
I don't know, but yesterday afternoon, late, whatever, I mean, you could hardly see anything.
Still getting good.
Never biting.
Yeah, but it had been sunny to put them up there.
Yeah.
It's just, these smallmouth are super conditional. They'll slide up on a flat when it's sunny and pull right back off in 20 foot of water when it's cloudy. It's the total opposite of largemouth.
But every time we've ever had one of these derbies, they're going to catch them.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's going to take probably 18 a day to make the cut. And knowing that, knowing what I've caught, looks like I'm going to have a couple extra days to sleep in and be rested up for Champlain. But
yeah, make it happen.
Yeah.
We always do.
Get after it.
Different year for me. Canada's off limits this year. 90% of the stuff that I fished in the past has been in Canada. The lakes opened up. I've kind of spread myself a little thin. I hated to do that, but I had to see it all. And you know, I didn't find much in practice. So today I'm going to one place that I fished in practice, maybe two, and then it's going to be a practice day for me. The big ones still live here. It's just a matter of finding them. And hopefully we can run into five today, because it's going to take a lot of waiting this one.
Benton with five fish here today. Always fun to follow a 27-pound bag no matter where you go. 15 pounds, 14 ounces.
Day number two, St. Lawrence. You know, kind of dug a big hole yesterday. Had 14 something, and here it doesn't cut it. You know, you've got to have about 18 pounds a day to make the top 40. So today we've got to catch you know, probably 20, 21 something to just make it in the top 40 and get some points back and, you know, make day three. So we're not going to run all over God's green earth like we did yesterday. We ran, you know, 112 miles for nothing. So we're going to kind of maximize our fishing time today and stay pretty close and, you know, just fish everything, fish some new stuff, some stuff I fished in practice, and try to get one of them big bags. It only takes, you know, a couple 3-pounders and 2 5-pounders to make it happen. So me and Benton are in about the same situation. We got to catch them. So we're going to get after it and see what we can do.
Gives him 25-13 and a very rare tough finish for group cook. Doesn't happen often.
Going in today, I have more confidence than I've had all week. You know, I didn't catch a lot of weight yesterday, but I figured out a bait that I'm getting some more bites on, and I feel like if I get it around them, I'll catch them. So we got sunlight today, which we didn't have yesterday, a little bit lighter wind. That's going to play a big factor, you know, the wind not blowing against the current. So I think the weights are actually going to go up today, but like I said, if we have a good day and do our job, we'll be right back in the thick of things.
About it earlier, it's the smallest things these smallmouth relate to, and going from a drop shot to fishing something on the bottom was huge. And I fished some of the same areas I fished the first day and caught that, you know, almost 20 pounds yesterday. So it's just little adjustments that you have to make, and it played off big.
Great finish. Look forward to seeing you at Champlain. Get down the road safe.